what we have did that we just created a class, okay, which was under form test. So this was package for that, and then this page objects, this we have created, and then we have built up the testng file. Okay, so let me run this one first. Someone is saying, in what about Cucumber VDD framework? Cucumber is separate framework. This is not part of our syllabus, so we will not cover this. Okay. So these are our topics. Okay, so let me run this one first. Okay, so test case started running. Wait.
हेलो बंधन सर।
यस
सर, लाइक आवर सिलेबस इज अबाउट टू फिनिश, सो आई एम जस्ट आस्किंग दैट कैन यू प्लीज हेल्प अस फॉर सम प्रोजेक्ट आल्सो, सो दैट वी कैन अप्लाई ऑल दीज टॉपिक्स ऑल टुगेदर इन प्रोजेक्ट।
यस श्योर, द प्रोजेक्ट इज देयर, सो आफ्टर दिस आई विल पेस्ट अ वीडियो, ओके, सो इन दैट वीडियो योर प्रोजेक्ट some sample test cases and the project what is all about, how to automate that. So once we complete this framework, so you have to run all your test cases in this framework only. Okay, I will upload this in on GitHub and you just need to download from there and just start working on your project. Okay, this will be 10 days task. Okay, so today 23, tomorrow there is 24, okay, so I will give you 10 days, means till February 5 you need to complete it. After February 5 there will be no help for the project purpose. If you are asking that, sir, this code is not running in my project, I am facing these issues, so that 10 days timeline you need to complete. In that 10 days timeline there should be no any mistake, like, sir, this syntactical error, right? At least if you are stuck somewhere, so you think that what the flow should be, then we can help you out. And if something we think that code is actually not working due to some reason, due to some other configurations or what, so we can help in that place, right? So if you are just stuck in system.set property and you're saying that, and you have not imported the jars, right, you have not put up the dependencies in Maven, so these type of questions should not be there. Okay, and all projects will be seen in GitHub only. Last session I have covered the GitHub. You need to complete all, you need to upload all your code in GitHub, and once you stuck somewhere, just send me the URL and the file that not working according to you, that you need to share with me. Okay, so that even if I am not in my system, even I am with my mobile, I can see that code on my mobile and then I can help you out. Okay, so
this project we have to do it individually or individually, in a group?
Yeah. This will be not too much large project. There will be 7 to 10 test cases, sample test cases from my side. Rest you need to write your own test cases and just automate them, right?
Okay.
Okay, so don't worry about project. So we will just, I said that there will be a project, so I will say that, and whosoever will complete project, so I can tell you guys, will be very helpful in your interview, and please be very careful in this framework. Okay, so this is actually a base, right? Whatever I am creating is just a base. If you go to the company, any framework you put at, there will be hybrid framework. So you can see at that period of time, you can see that these all concepts will be implemented there. Maybe they have extended some more properties on their frameworks according to their project, what this that project is all about, right? So these all properties will be integrated there. There will be page object model, and just like we have implemented here, similar to that one. Maybe there will be 100 classes for page object. Here we have integrated one or two. Okay, so this is about the framework, right? So just let me start first and then finish it. Okay, so we have seen that we are test cases run 2, pass 2. I got a message in mobile that someone is saying that recording is not started. Recording is already started, so don't worry about the recordings. Okay, so test cases pass 2, right? But let me go to this one, this form test, and in this form test there is a contact form. Okay, so like this, we have in last session created this one. Okay, so we have also used this priority, which priority we are going to do. This I have left to you. Any one of you have completed? I think no. So if I have completed, then it's okay. Not completed, then it's also okay. Okay, I will create one more test case here, and just let me remove the priority. Now you guys are aware of this, so I will not prioritize my test case here. This method I have left to you. You need to complete this. Okay, the simple drop down that you have to handle, the 5 to 7 line codes. Okay, but you can see what is this I have implemented, this email ID. What is this is a web element, right? You can see here, if you press on control, this method I have used. Just click on this and you will be redirected. This is your page object model. Okay, now one thing I have to do, once any of my test case gets fail, I have to see first that. Okay, suppose I have to get the title of this site, this automationpractice.com, and I have to get the title. Okay, so let me use this. Guys, at least start writing code, some small codes, start writing, so that you can understand in a way. Okay, so means day by day your practice will be better and you will be able to do that. Okay, so verify title. Okay, and here also we will use this driver dot get. Now anyone can ask here that, sir, here again I am going to write this automationpractice.com. So I have actually used one parameter in testng. Okay, so that URL should come from testng. Okay, so I have already taken multiple session on testng. Okay, so now you just need to do in that way, right? So daily basis, use as much as testng will explore, your framework will be better. Okay, here for just showing you to fail test cases, I am using this one. Okay, otherwise you should use this URL from testng parameter. Okay, this should be base URL. And system dot set get property, and then user dot dir, that will be your base URL. Okay, this way you can work on. Okay, means as much as you want to modify your code, there will be always possibility. Okay, I will get this title and this URI. I will go and then driver dot get title. Okay, and where I have to store this title? Inside string variable. Site title. Okay, so here I will apply assertion, assert dot assert equals. Here I will pass actual is this. Suppose I am expecting abc.com. okay, so this will fail. Because the actual site title is what? If I go to automation practice.com, what is the site title here? My store, right? This is title, whatever written here. Okay, so I want to get this, and I am matching what? I am matching that with the abc.com. No, this, that's my store, so this will not match, so this will fail. Once this will fail, I have told you a mechanism separately, taken 1 hour session for that in last session, maybe last to last session. About anyone can tell me what was that?
Soft assertion.
No, not soft assertion. How will you identify that particular test case is fail? And if that gets fail, we have to perform task. I have actually covered one topic for that.
Yes, when the test case get fail, we capture the screenshot of that screen.
I am not talking about the screenshot, taking the screenshot. I am just talking about what was the topic, what was the name of the topic. I am not asking the mechanism how to use that. That I have covered. No.
Verify.
Listeners.
Yes.
There was 1 hour session for that. I think that you guys are not practicing. Guys, actually start writing codes. Revise with the videos, right? So here my test case will fail. Okay, so now I have to move to create one more package where I will store all my listeners. I am creating only one. Okay, guys, think whatever I am building the framework, if you think that more than sufficient, not, there will be always chance to modify your framework. Yes, Salish.
Yeah, can you please tell me that? So how you have created listeners once again?
See, Salil, that's actually 1 hour session that I have dedicated. After this session,
yeah, actually what happened, sorry, what you have given that framework, and I was trying to open it to my office laptop, but that was not opening due to some office restriction. That's why miss it is that's why I'm asking.
Okay, in that case, you need to watch that recording again. If I will spending 1 hour here, so this will be never complete. Okay, but I am doing that same task here also. So you just need to see it again. On depth, I will not go, but you can see it again. So here I have created a framework, package, which is listeners. Okay, just go to this listener package and create a listener class. You have whole week, full week for saying that, right? So you must say that I have missed the last class or whatever the problem was. Okay, so no worries, just focus here. So this class I have created in inside listeners package, okay, and this listener will implement a class, sorry, implement a interface. Actually I have two different laptops, just like he said, I have office laptop, that's why my keys, it takes time to find, right? Implement iTest listener is the interface which have or listening classes. Whether your framework is getting fail, whatever, okay. Now this will have some methods. Right click, go to source, and get then override implemented method. That's why I have covered each and every topic separately, okay, so that once I will integrate them, you will not face problem while understanding them, okay. So let me remove all this garbage. Okay, so here you can see on test start, if any test will start, that will come inside this. If any test will success, that will come inside this. Any test case will fail, that will come inside this. Skip then this and this, right? So my test case is getting failed, so I have my pointer will come here, but listener will only understand if you paste these lines, right? Means these syntax there, where you can this testng.xml file can understand that listener are introduced in your project, okay. So if you want to write it separately, you can write this. I will just copy and paste because in last session we have covered that, okay. So inside listeners package, I have inside listeners tags, I have integrated this. My listener is under listener package, right? This is listener package, and inside that listener is the class, not listeners, right? So you need to correct it, okay. So we have used this, okay. Now this will understand, okay, listener are introduced in my project, any something gets fail, pass, so I have to work according to that, okay. Now why this error is coming, maybe one more bracket required, okay. So once any test case will fail, it will come under this on test failure, okay. So sys out, I am called for fail test case. Test case, okay. And if you want to get the method name, then I have told that result, this is the variable, right? And get method dot get method name, okay. So it will capture the method name which is failed, okay, one by one, okay. So here I will run this, and once any test case will fail, so in my case what test case is getting failed, in my case this verify title is getting failed, and to be treated as a test case you need to use @ test annotation, okay. Just go and run as test ng suite. Now you can see test run 3, passes 2, fails 1. Just go refresh your project, okay. So their test output folder is present. Inside this index.html file, which will show your results, and just go here and paste this file here to watch it. That three methods run, one failed, two passed, right? This is verify title, which is failed. Now what is saying? That java.lang.assertionError expected abc.com but found my store. Okay, now it given you the reason for that. Okay, now what you need to do, you can see once the test case is failed, that then your listener method was invoked, failed method, and I am called for failed, and this is method name test verify title. I am called for failed test, and this is your method name. I have not given a space here, otherwise there was a space. Okay, this is actually capturing the method name. Doesn't matter if test case is failing or passing, this will capture. Okay, now my task is to capture the screenshot for any failed test case. Okay, so again there is a code required for that. I will copy, because we have already covered those things. Okay, so I'll quickly copy, and you can also see all codes present in your website. Day by day I will be updating, so if you want to practice, so whatever we have teach, same way you will get here, so you will not face problem in while understanding, because same tutor, same code, so it will be better to practice on. Okay, just you need to click on this copy button and this code will be copied. Okay, so I will just go inside this method in build up class, because see where I need to put the screenshot code. I have three places. First, because we are building the framework, so this understanding is very important, where to put which code where, right? Just like screenshot code, suppose in your test, in your project there are 500 test cases, small project, 500 test cases. Okay, now 30 of them fail, so in those 500 methods will you go and write this screenshot code? If that's fail, then so if you say that better option is to write in this listener, because this is getting failed. Okay, so every method which is getting failed will come here, so write it here. But see, tomorrow you have to perform some other task also, like you have to perform like any other task while failing a test case. So what will you do? Suppose he said that you need to perform these three or four tasks when my test case is getting failed. Okay, now will you write code for those tasks again in listener? Because every time when it gets pass or gets fail, then you will call this? No. So what else? The buildup class will have all common code. This is basically your utility class. Okay, today we are learning, we will be using basic code for that. You have already told about the Selenium 4.0 feature for taking the particular element screenshot, right? So you can use that. In my case, I am just using the simple one. Okay, now once you will start working in your framework, use that code in that place. Everything is same, just need to better out your code. Okay, so here I will use that in this buildup class. I will write that common buildup class, and I will write that code here. Guys, wait 1 second. हाँ भाई, अरे यार अभी 10 मिनट बाद आ जाना, 15-20 मिनट बाद आना, ठीक है? अभी कुछ काम कर रहा हूँ, तुम आ जाओ 5:30। ओके ओके, सो आई विल फर्स्ट रिमूव दिस ऑल. ओके, this is not required, this is also not required. Okay, for this we need Apache Common IO. Okay, I think that these will be need, because in newer Selenium versions they have removed that. Okay, so Apache Common IO dependency in case you are working in framework and you face any problem, let me know. I will write that code and paste in this website. Okay, in case any you problem you face. Okay, so here copy and paste, and where in pom.xml this dependency. Okay, now if I'll go building up, if I'll go and try to import, it will allow me to do that. Okay, this is your screenshot code. Now doesn't matter which test case is getting fail, it will come to first listener, and listener will send information to this method that I am, this method, particular method was failed and you need to capture screenshot for this. Okay, so the way it will work. Okay, so now, but how listener will tell this method that any method was failed, somehow this method failed, verify title. Okay, and once any method failed, just because of we have provide information about the listeners, so testng will do one thing immediately. Actually listener are the heart of the project, so immediately it will tell that this method is failed. Okay, now just go and call the listener class and tell him that on test method should be called just because this method is failed. Okay, now it immediately came here that I am failed, now tell me what I have to do. So then whatever you will instruct here by your code, it will do that. You said that just first which method failed, tell me. So same task it has done. Okay, so just capture the method name string, failed method name, okay, is equal to result dot get method dot get method name. Okay, so what this method will do, it will capture the method name which is failed. Okay, now your next task is to get to call that particular failed screenshot code. Okay, so just because that screenshot code we have already written, so we will tell this method that we need to call screenshot method, which is present in what class? Buildup class. Okay, but how this buildup class will know about this all information? You can do one thing, just extend buildup. Okay, now that method is present inside this. I hope you understand this. This normal inheritance concept we have used, which actually we started using once we have started the Java code. Okay, so I think there should be no problem. okay. Now I will call this method, screenshot code method, okay, that you need to now capture the screenshot. Okay, wait, but there is a problem here. See, first I will tell you the flow of the project first, okay, and then you will understand the problem. See, let me, once I will run my testng file, now immediately listeners came into picture. Suppose I say to you that you have to go to this place to that place, and this is the direction that you have to follow from the beginning. To immediately this suite understand that now listeners are in the picture, okay, then class name Apache common buildup, okay, this and this, okay. Inside this Apache common buildup, I have not used any information like @test, okay. So of course, if we have not used here @test, so this is not going to run. So this will be not treated as a test case. These two methods will be not treated as a test case. So what testng will do? It will come here, that framework, and this is actually not required. This is not part of our code. Okay, this was just a garbage which were initially present. Okay, now form test and then contact form test. So once I called this, so it went here, contact form test class. Now in contact form test class, what it will look, any @before test, sorry, @before suite, no, not any @before test, no, there is not any @before class, yes. So this is here, then it is set, it set up the driver, okay, and the driver is set up for the this method and this method, okay, because we have actually set up before class, so already it got set up, okay. And in last session I have briefly covered why we need to do this, okay. So if you are facing problem here, so you need to watch first session again and then relate that, okay. So here verify title, suppose my this test case is running, driver is set up, here URL is something else, here URL is something else, because there will may be multiple URL to be redirected. Now the driver, this driver has information about this URL, and this driver has information about the this URL, okay, but the failed test case is that this, and just because of this listener is invoked and listener went here, okay. But once listener went here, then it has two drivers. It said that which URL I need to invoke, okay. So for that, the current working life driver will be this line, just once in a used, any of the URL, any of the object you want to use globally, you can write this line. I will declare here web driver is equal to null, and I am not defining this as globally, in this local only. Why this I am doing? Because the failed test case, this driver will be not same everywhere. This will be created once any test case gets fail, then first of all that driver should null, okay, driver should be null, and it should invoke that particular failed test case information, right. So this line will help you to get this particular driver, okay, which is failed in the contact form test, yeah, this one, right. So this will invoked. Now it has told that automationpractice.com, whatever you need to get this driver, you just get by. And what this says, that this result variable will get test class, get real class, and inside this declare field is what driver. If this field was dot get declare field, if this was inside this, if this was driver 5, suppose this like this driver 5, then you have to use driver 5 here, okay, because everywhere that driver 5 object was used, so you need to use here driver 5. So this, that's why every one, anywhere if I am creating web driver driver, so everywhere this is same, okay. Common things, if you will keep in your framework, then it will be easy to manage everything, right? So just like this, driver object will be created, and of course get instant method will help to get the information from that, right? So that this way will work, right? And we will pass this driver information, that for particular test case here, okay. So if I'll pass in this method, then this method will get this driver, and for that method only it will take the screenshot which is failed, okay. But I am passing the driver but not receiving here, so I have to first receive here, okay. But see what error is coming. Change visibility of test screenshot to be to protected. Why this is saying protected? Why this is not saying public? What this is, why this is not saying private? Because minimal it is responding, right? Because this buildup class is in different package and listener is in different package. So maximum, minimum what should be used for that? Minimum what should be used to call it? So if you want to use any method beyond any package, then and you are using inheritance, then you can use protected. If you are not using inheritance, then it should be public, okay. So here I have declared this as public, okay. Now this error should gone, okay. Now this is asking me to actually try catch, right? Because this is calling, this driver is actually maybe not present or some other cases. Just like in this screenshot method also, it is asking me to surround with try catch, because which method I am calling is screenshot, right? And maybe this path is not present, maybe your file is missing, that's why you need to attach with this surround with the try catch, okay. So that I have did here. Now just remove this, it's just garbage, it looks okay. Now this I have did here, okay. Now let me run it, will it work? Let me run it and see the error. Listeners cannot access the member of the class contact form with modifiers, right? Now I will tell you the problem first. what the problem is coming. First of all, you need to read the error carefully. I came here. java.lang.illegal access. Access, if anywhere access comes, it means that either public, private, protected, modifier is the reason. So you need to increase the scope in that period of time, right? So here if it's saying that class listeners cannot access the member of class form test, contact form test with modifier task, it is telling you everything. Inside form test, contact form test means this is test case class with modifiers. Now it's telling that this class has used a method which modifier is not able to call by listeners, and listeners were invoked when my test case was failed, and in my framework only one test case is getting failed, right? So this way I will identify then some problem with this scope of this method, because only this is getting called through listeners, because this is actually failing. Okay, so we need to increase this scope, but first of all you need to understand if this were unexpected, then how? Yes
sir, we have to make it public so that the code will work.
Yeah, but I want to let you know, in case you are working with your framework, then how will you identify? Today I told you, or maybe you knowing, but some unexpected errors come, then how will you debug that? First of all, you have seen the line, right? Listeners, you can mute yourself. So listener, inside listener, this is a class listener, cannot access member of the form test, this modifiers, and if you go much deeper, you will see listeners cannot access form test, contact form test, modifiers, right? So means listener is not able to understand this method, okay, in because this listener was called, okay. I will put up debug here, okay, and one here. Obvious, this is null. Actually it is not getting this driver information. Why? Because this driver, now same problem, this listener is in different package, this actually, and this particular test case is in different package, right? And I want to access this one, in different package, but its scope is default. So if I want to access this in different package, then minimum it should be protected. But I am also not using inheritance for this method, right? For this method I am not using inheritance, so this should be public. If I was extending through the inheritance, then that may be protected, but in this case this is not accessible, just because listener is in different package, contact form objects is in different package, right? And I am not accessing through inheritance, then it should be public. But how would I know? Actually I got the information from here that this is okay. You need to put a debug here, because I think that this is not accessible, it's not able to understand. That means this problem with this two or three lines, okay. So I put up debugger here, and just because of this is not using here, okay. So again, and inside my form test, let me put debugger here, not this one. This is the method. I will not put here, I will put here, okay. These all running fine, okay. Now let me just run this, run as debug as test ng suite, okay. Now see, this line, redirection line, driver dot get title worked, okay. Now see information, this it came to contact form test, and till here it ran fine, okay, because driver information it has given, driver, driver has value, my store site title is also given, okay, but failed. So listener called, listener called, say move one step forward and see. So maybe where is the listener? Okay, now failed, then one step more, edit source, lookup path, what happened? Now you can see that in this place this XML suit, let me run it again. Some problem came here. Let me run it again. Right click, debugger, test and issue. Let me close all this. Put this console below. Now how will it come here? This, once this is done, then I get frustrated. Okay, let's run it through again. Let me first check the debugger, put a debugger here also. Okay, one by one we will go. testng.xml file, debug as testng suit. Why this is coming here? Okay, so let me step over. Oh yeah, I need to fix it. What happened? Close all. Wait guys, if we'll not fix this, then close this. From where it will come down, display open console. Okay, let's run like this. Okay, here I will run this testng.xml file. Right click, debug as testng suit. Okay, no problem, some problems may be coming. So first, where it will come? Okay, first of all it came to your file. And which was that file? Let me open the dem2 form test, contact form test. For first, it will come inside this contact form test. Okay, inside this contact form test, driver will be initialized, and you can see that driver is initialized, and then it see the values drop down test and email field. This ran successfully, and these breakpoints variables step over. Where this step over? Let me close all this again. My Eclipse got settings. If this come down, okay, let's close it. First, let me put my this class here. Run as okay. Console. Contact form test. Inside this, I have put a debugger, and let me put debugger everywhere, and then let me go to listeners. Okay, if variables will be there, then I will show you. Otherwise, skip this. Debugger is test and distribute. Okay, this window is open. I will close previous one, which is getting, which is causing confusion. Okay, so it went to this line, driver dot get title. Currently it is here. Okay, now I have to step over. This is button for stepping over. Click, then you can see if in console if that is present. Variable value came here. Okay, let's just fix it and then we will do it later on. Okay, terminate some means here I was trying to apply debugger, but some settings got it gone up, and then immediately it I need to fix it. I need to Google it how to make this correct, and then I will make a video and show it to you. Okay, but meanwhile let me get back to the topic. Just run this file testng.xml and then run it, and it will be fixed. It will capture the screenshot for you. Okay, because we have not run through debugger. Why this is console should come here. Class listener cannot access member class form test. Same problem is coming. Modifiers. I have did it in correct place or saved it or not. Let me check that. Contact form test. Let me run it again. let close it and see the error again. Cannot access class form test, contact form test with modifier this. Okay, so here we need to go to the listeners, and then inside listeners we have put up this get real instance, and then calling where is my screenshot method, this is here. Okay, now it is coming here inside this string title grabber route get title, and then this method is public, verify title will be called by this listener, and then listener will invoke here, and then driver is getting captured, that driver is here, let me make it public. Okay, because this will be also not accessible, or this. Okay, now let me run it again. So this way, if any issues comes, you need to check what that line of issue is written there, and then you can fix that. Okay, so it will show you the three test case run, two pass and one fail. Okay, so the problem with was here I made that method public. Okay, but the problem is was that even though I made this method public, but this driver was not public, this variable was not public, so whatever I was using information was limited to this method level only. I am not audible, guys.
Audible.
Okay, so I made this public and this variable will be also accessed, because this variable I am using beyond the package, right? Listener is beyond the package, that's why. So right click and refresh this project. This screenshot is present. I will show you where the location I have saved, and go to this new folder, weekend framework, and this screenshot. Okay, suppose I open it through Internet Explorer or Firefox. You can see this screenshot you capture. Now in this place you can put up your code. Okay, so means for particular element screenshot you want to take which is getting failed, due to what reason, due to this tab get title, so screenshot that is actually covered in the Selenium 1.4 Selenium 4.0, then you can put that code in this place, buildup, inside buildup class. Okay, I will make this correct. Okay, but see, I think that debugging is already covered by Sumit. I just wanted to show you the problem, how to fix it, but somehow I am using the old version of the Eclipse, so it is causing me problem. Okay, but I will make up a video and show you how to debug the code, and we will show you once I will fix this. Okay, so this is from my side. Tomorrow separate session will be started on Jenkins, and Sumit will be taking that session. Two things remaining here that I wanted to tell you. First of all, to be very clear, most important thing is that project. So whatever you have learned in 3 months, so these are the most important topic is the test ng, okay, and the page object model, right? I could cover the cucumber, because saying that I have a knowledge about cucumber is very modern nowadays, but the reality is that cucumber can handle only API frameworks, okay, API automation frameworks or small projects, right? If you are designing very big project, then you cannot do all your tasks with the cucumber, okay, because that will not be so relevant for that. So TestNG is a wide framework used by the developers also for the unit testing, okay. This page object model, which is very important to your interview point, and then the most important thing comes is the locators. They will ask you in to write a locator, right? Web elements handling, right? The question may be coming that web elements, how can I handle web elements? And here one more question left which I need to say you, that if someone says now in your project, in your framework, 10 test cases gets fail, how will you run only failed test cases? This is one of the common interview question many people will ask that. I will suggest you not to focus on this question. Answer is very simple, but you need to explore this test output folder, okay. Inside this test output folder, all the answers are present which interviewer can deviate you in between, that he will try to misguide you from your logics. But if you have seen this folder correctly, then your answer. How? See, once any test case got failed, there is a testng fail.xml file created, right? And see the pattern of its creation. Methods I have already covered, so you can see that listener was the responsible for the catching up the failed test case. Name of the method, what is previously it was not present inside your framework. If any test case gets failed, then only it will be created, okay. You can see name of the method will be test and then in brackets failed. Now which class under in form test, contact form test. Which method in verify title, this method was failed, right? Include name init driver, means under it any method, it's any method internally it's using, yes. This contact form test verify title method fail, internally it's using what, init driver. So it has told you about this also. Maybe this method is written correctly, but internally it is using this init driver. So init driver is also causing, maybe cause of that fail test case. So it is telling you that also, okay. Now if 100 methods or 10 test cases get fail, every method will be included here, right? This is one trick question in interviews, that how will you run only failed test cases. Just go and run this file, right click and run as testng test. You need to not do to
sir, and how can we run like only even test case or only odd test cases?
Even or odd test cases means even odd test cases, what means?
Like sir, even method test cases, I have also seen these kind of questions, okay, they ask in interview.
Alternate test cases he might be referring, the execution of alternate test cases.
Execution of alternate test cases means you need to explore your question. If they have asked something, so if that is you should ask them that give me an example for that, okay. So same here I will ask that what event test cases, maybe you want to say that you need to skip one test case one by one, right? You need to skip the first test case should not run, and second should run, then third should be skipped, and fourth should be run.
Yes sir, alternate.
Okay, brother, I have to see that also, because I think that this is not a relevant task that I have ever did. Okay, but see, this will be not done through TestNG, that I am pretty sure. I can write a logic for that, for running that. I can write a logic for that. Okay, just like what I can do, I can declare a counter here, like in this buildup class, and then initial test case will be one, then that should be running. This way I will write some common class where this should be picked up. But in TestNG there is no such concept present. Like if you say that priority wise, if you go to the priority 2, 4, 5, 6 and this is not relevant to do here, I think.
One strategy we can use might be that we can group our test cases, one or two. In that case, we can call a group also.
That strategy can be used, that I name the group even, or and the others one is the odd. But see, this I can say that a very funny question also, because groups are not used for this purpose, for testing up the even test case or odd test cases. He may just tweak this question, like if you want to run all your regression test cases, okay, so just go and group them, name the group that regression, right, and name the group sanity, so all sanity will run, okay. But this tweak question comes, I want to run all event test cases, we have never to do this, right? So that's why I am saying that you need to ask other further that what he wants to do actually, right? Means if he is just tweaking up, then you can answer him that you can use group, you can set up the priority, that priority is to then run out, or you can write the logic for that. But if you are grouping name, giving the name of the groups like this, then if you really working in project, then this is not actually okay. But yeah, for answering purpose you can ask questions to him and then answer. But see, if I next question will be, if you have 500 test cases, will you go and run all your and write everywhere that group is actually even and this method is odd? In 500 places we have to write this even or odd, that's not practical. So better is to write some logic that will be 2 or 3 line logic, and then that will be working everywhere. Suppose tomorrow 300 methods more included in that project, then what? So if he is tweaking that, he is just checking your logic. So you need to tell him logic, not these concepts. Okay. Okay, so thank you for attending.